Hi, today let's look at the difference between osteomalacia and osteoporosis. So they both sound similar, they look similar clinically, but then they are apples and oranges. So let's make it clear that you can actually make out a difference between osteoporosis and osteomalacia 100% only by pathological examination, only by a bone biopsy, right? But then there are several clues clinically that we can look at. Today's presentation is about that. So when you look at bone, it is composed of matrix as well as mineral. Around 70% of bone is actually mineral and 30% is matrix. This is not unlike your concrete, where you have a steel scaffolding into which the concrete is poured. So basically, bone is similar to concrete. So you have iron rods, which are matrix. So instead of iron rods, you have a matrix which is formed of collagen, and you have a matrix which is formed of calcium phosphorus, calcium phosphate hydroxyapatite crystals. So why should we differentiate between these two entities? Because the prognosis is vastly different between osteoporosis and osteomalacia. Osteomalacia can be cured or improved dramatically, whereas osteoporosis requires specific therapeutics. And radiologically, there is a clinical overlap. So you can have X-rays which look very similar in both osteomalacia and osteoporosis, making the differentiation difficult. And most important and most critical thing for you to note is that when you measure a bone mineral density, it will be identical in both osteomalacia and osteoporosis. So just a low bone mineral density should not make you think in terms of osteoporosis alone. So many physicians think that low bone mineral density means osteoporosis. Low bone mineral density means that there is less grams per centimeter square of bone that is present. And this could be either osteomalacia or osteoporosis. Okay. So what is, in a sense, osteomalacia? So it is basically undermineralization of the bone, where the calcium and phosphorus are not adequately deposited. So why can that happen? That can happen because enough calcium and phosphorus are not being absorbed into the body, either because of nutritional calcium deficiency or vitamin D deficiency. So the vitamin D is deficient, the calcium does not get into the body. So vitamin D is responsible for appropriate absorption of the calcium that you take. So if there is vitamin D deficiency, there can be indirect calcium deficiency and the matrix deficiency results. And a matrix deficiency causes osteomalacia. Right? You could have a condition where you have phosphate wasting. So phosphorus is abundantly present in our foodstuffs. So dietary phosphate deficiency is not common. Right? But you can have a phosphate wasting disorder where the kidney loses phosphorus from the body, and this can result in osteomalacia. Rare genetic disorders could also cause osteomalacia. So rickets is nothing but osteomalacia in growing bones. Okay, so if a growing bone gets undermineralized for nutritional or other reasons, you can have rickets. So what is osteoporosis? It is due to reduced bone mass. So both the matrix and mineral are proportionately reduced. And important cause is primary osteoporosis. Most people who have osteoporosis, they have parents who have osteoporosis. All right. So usually there is a family history of fractures in those who already have a fracture. There's something called secondary osteoporosis. This refers to primary osteoporosis. Secondary osteoporosis refers to hormonal or other disorders which can result in osteoporosis. Chronic inflammatory states like rheumatoid arthritis can also cause osteoporosis. How? The inflammatory mediators reduce bone formation or bone turnover. They interfere with bone turnover, resulting in osteoporosis. Glucocorticoid intake also can cause osteoporosis. So if you have a secondary cause for osteoporosis, so stopping that secondary cause would prevent the worsening of osteoporosis. Otherwise, you need to treat like a primary osteoporosis using agents which improve the bone mineral density. Okay. So a rare genetic disorder known as osteogenesis imperfecta leads to abnormal matrix formation. The matrix is less amount of matrix is formed, and whatever matrix is formed is not healthy, resulting in osteoporosis. Okay, so this again is a primary osteoporosis because it's a genetic condition. So how do you differentiate between osteoporosis and osteomalacia clinically? One is that osteoporosis occurs in older age unless it is secondary osteoporosis. So you can have a 30-year-old getting osteoporosis because he or she is taking steroids for an inflammatory condition. So post-renal transplant patients could have osteoporosis because they are on steroid therapy. Okay, so not many symptoms, but fractures with minimal trauma. Okay, bone pains, which are not a prominent feature of osteoporosis. And calcium, phosphorus, alkaline phosphatase, and albumin are usually normal in osteoporosis. So the calcium and phosphorus metabolism are normal, but still the bone is weak because the matrix is weak and because of various reasons that I had discussed before. Osteomalacia is a condition where you can have a lot of bone pain involving spine, pelvis, and lower limbs. And this is a characteristic feature of osteomalacia. And when you do a blood test, you will find that the phosphorus and calcium are abnormal. You can have very low phosphorus levels in phosphate wasting disorders. And you can have low calcium if there is nutritional or vitamin D nutritional calcium deficiency or vitamin D deficiency. And alkaline phosphatase is characteristically high in all osteomalacic conditions. Okay, so this is how you differentiate between osteoporosis and osteomalacia. Though they look similar, they are cousins, but then they are different. And radiologically also, you can make out the difference between osteomalacia and osteoporosis. In osteomalacia, you get looser zone. This is an example of looser zone. So where you see a small fracture-like lesion in the medial border of the femur, both sides. And if it is, especially if it is symmetrical, it is a looser zone. Sometimes you can have a real fracture and then mistake it for a looser zone. If it is bilaterally symmetrical, you need to think in terms of looser zone. And how do X-rays in osteoporosis look? So X-rays in osteoposis, in a normal vertebral X-ray, you will see the striations of the matrix. So you get vertical striations that you see on the X-ray. Here, those vertical striations are absent. The vertical and horizontal striations are absent. So indicating that the bone matrix has reduced, that's number one. Another thing is that it's a silent fracture. You can see that the heights of the vertebrae are reduced here, L1 to L3 vertebrae. So the height of the vertebrae are reduced in this X-ray. So this indicates that there is a fracture that is happening here, but this patient may be totally asymptomatic. So to summarize, osteomalacia is more symptomatic. It will have looser zone on X-ray. And you also get abnormal calcium, phosphorus, alkaline phosphatase, these parameters abnormal in the blood. So if you're seeing a patient who has come to you with a bone mineral density report, which is low, and especially if the person is young or less than 50 years of age, so think strongly in terms of osteomalacia in addition to osteoporosis. So with that, I'd like to conclude. Thank you.